gardeners, welcome to another video on my channel. My name is Trisha for anyone that's new, and today we are going to be talking all about lizards. So I'm really excited for this topic because it's one that I've wanted to do for so long now, and now I'm finally getting to it. So I'm not sure if any of you guys have ever experienced this where there's one type of lizard that you really, really want. It's like a dream lizard. But for some reason, maybe you just don't have enough space, enough time, enough money, or enough experience to actually get that type of a lizard. So it's just like one of those lizards that you're just never going to be able to attain, and it's really, really depressing. But this video is going to show you some alternatives to those really challenging lizards that are very similar, but much easier and more reasonable to attain and keep in captivity. So maybe this can open your eyes to a lizard that is easier and more reasonable for you to keep. Maybe you'll just learn more about lizards because honestly, what better way to spend your time in this quarantine than learning about lizards? So I'm going to start off with my number one most obsessed with lizard, my dream lizard that I honestly don't think I'll ever be able to get because of all of these challenging reasons, and that is a caiman lizard. So caiman lizards are just stunning, stunning animals. They're so beautiful. Their scientific name is Dracaena. They're usually 2 to 4 feet, so because of that, they're going to require an enclosure that is 6 feet by 3 feet by 4 feet tall as a minimum. So that alone is just like a crazy amount of space. Another thing that is difficult about them is that they love to swim. So if I were to ever get a caiman lizard, I would literally need an entire room just dedicated to the caiman lizard, and it would need a huge swimming area, a huge pool, and a huge basking area. And it's just so unreasonable for where I live now, and I don't know if I'll ever be in a situation where I can keep one properly. So it's just one of those lizards that's just like, darn it, like I really want it, but it's not gonna happen. Another thing that can be a little bit tricky with caiman lizards is that they primarily eat snails. They don't really eat much of anything else. Some people are able to get other things in their diet, but literally what they mainly eat is just snails, and that can be kind of hard to come by. I think a lot of people go to Chinese restaurants or something to where they can get snails, like a ton of frozen snails. I have no idea, but like that also just makes it a little bit more challenging. So with all of these challenges, because of their size and the requirements for the space that they need and their diet and just everything that they need, it's so difficult and just unattainable for me. But there is a lizard that is very, very similar to caiman lizards, but they're way more reasonable when you're thinking about keeping a lizard. So this is the Chinese crocodile lizard, also known as, I'm probably gonna mess this up, Chinosaurus crocodilurus. That totally sounds like I just said it with like a sock in my mouth or something. That did not sound right. But that is their scientific name. These lizards are basically like mini caiman lizards. If you look at them, like their scale type, they kind of have this like alligator type looking texture. They have the same type of like coloring on them as caiman lizards. They're very bright. They're very gorgeous. What makes these lizards so much easier than caiman lizards is their size. So the size alone is just, I mean, compared to a caiman lizard that's 2 to 4 feet, these guys are only going to get 16 inches. So that alone just makes it so much easier to care for. These guys also love the water, very similar to caiman lizards, which again is so much easier because they're so much smaller. You can provide that water area and keep it in your house rather than needing an entire room for a caiman lizard. And one of the reasons I like caiman lizards so much is because I really like that they swim and like that type of tropical setup. I would love to be able to set something up like that. So to actually be able to do that for a smaller lizard is also just appealing to me as well. And then when it comes to diet, they do eat snails very much like caiman lizards, but they also eat a lot of other insects as well, which again just makes keeping them so much easier than a caiman lizard. So they're definitely something that is easier to keep in a household and just be able to take care of rather than a caiman lizard. I'll always have mad love and respect for caiman lizards. They are my number one. But when it comes to picking a choice as a pet, I think that I would have to go with the Chinese crocodile lizard. So that is the first substitution lizard, and now we are going to move on to the next one. So the next one that we are going to talk about is the Nile monitor. So you guys see these all the time at reptile shows. We see the tiny little babies. They're so cute. these guys are gonna get massive. And when I say massive, I mean like 7 to 8 feet massive. They also love water as well. So again, you're just gonna need like an entire room. You're gonna need a pool. You're gonna need a basking area. Nile monitors as well, like with any monitor, they can be aggressive. They're very, very highly intelligent. And they're just very, very challenging to work with. Monitors in general, because of that intelligence, and they have really sharp teeth, and they're just very, very challenging animals. And then when you add that size to it, it just makes it nearly impossible for most normal people to be able to keep an animal like that as a pet. So if you have a dream of keeping a Nile monitor or any other monitor in general that's just way too big and challenging and not realistic for you to keep as a pet, a good option as a pet would be an Aki monitor. Aki monitors also go as Varanus acanthurus, and they are so much smaller than Nile monitors, which makes it so much easier to keep them. So when you're looking at a Nile monitor that gets 7 to 8 feet, the Aki monitor is only going to be 24 to 28 inches. So that makes a huge difference. And what's really cool about this is that they are still monitors. They're going to have the same types of behaviors and personalities and just like the intelligence. You're going to get the same exact thing in a smaller package. I'm sure there are differences among the species, and again, personality is different among every independent animal, but for the most part, it's still going to be a monitor. It's going to have those same really cool aspects to it. It's just going to be a smaller size that's easier for you to take care of. So I think that it's an amazing substitute if you want a monitor and you just don't have the space or the experience or the time or the money to get a huge, huge, huge responsibility like that. Definitely go for an Aki monitor, because I think that you'll just be as happy and you will be able to provide a great life for an animal that doesn't need that much space. So the next lizards that we're going to be talking about, the challenging lizard is the tegu. So a lot of people keep tegus. Tegus are amazing lizards. They're kind of like people, honestly, that keep them, they think they're like dogs. They let them roam around their house and stuff, and like they can be domesticated and like really, really tame. However, every animal is different, and the fact is that tegus do get pretty large, and that alone can make them challenging. They're usually around 3 feet, and they are like really, really beefy. They get really, really sharp teeth as well. So that's something to keep an eye out for, and that can be challenging for a lot of people, especially if you just have like a really beefy, big lizard that can have a little bit of an attitude that maybe just doesn't have that personality that's as easygoing as others. It can be really challenging. So, or maybe people just don't have enough space to be able to provide a good home for one. So my alternative for this is kind of strange, but I'm going to explain why I think it's a similar, good, reasonable substitute for a tegu. So my tegu substitute is a jeweled lacerta. So these lizards don't really look the same. Tegus are, again, much larger. The jeweled lacerta is only going to reach a size of 24 inches compared to a tegu, which is like 3 feet. Another thing about jeweled lacertas is that they're like bright blue or green, and they just like totally look different than a tegu. But the thing that's similar between these two lizards are their personalities and their behaviors. So the jeweled lacerta, something that I really like about them is they have this forked tongue that they stick out in order to taste everything around them. And that's exactly what tegus do as well. So not all lizards do this, and that is something that tegus do that a lot of people love, and that's one thing that I love about them. I think it's so cool that they can do that. So I really like that jeweled lacertas have that same exact behavior as well. And again, like their personalities, anyone that's kept a jeweled lacerta, I've never kept one myself. They're one of my dream lizards. But for the people that have kept them, they always compare them to tegus. They say that they're mini tegus because of their personality. So the personalities are what make them so similar to tegus, and they're just so much smaller and easier to take care of. So it's just a great alternative if maybe you don't have the space or the time or whatever it may be for a tegu, to get a smaller option that will be easier to take care of. So the next challenging lizard that we're going to be talking about, I'm basically just going to cram it all into one group, and that is chameleons. Chameleons are amazing lizards, but they are not always the best for handling. And because of that, they can be a little challenging, especially veiled chameleons, because they pack a lot of sass in them. Like, they are so grumpy all the time. Like, you can't tame them down. Bamba rarely ever has a bad attitude with me, and he's just all bluff. If he, like, gets angry, I'm like, oh, just shut up. Like, I know you don't mean it. But like chameleons in general, a lot of the time, they don't really handling very well. They're very prone to stress. They're more of an observing animal, and they don't drink from water bowls. So there are just different aspects to them that can be challenging. I feel like a lot of people just want chameleons because they're so popular. They're so cool. They have all of these really cool behaviors. They have these independent eyes that are all over the place. They're just so cool. And that's why people want them, but they're really upset when they can't really handle them. So I think a great alternative to a chameleon would actually be a false chameleon. They also go by Anolis barbatus. Again, don't know if I'm pronouncing that correctly, but I'm trying my best here. But false chameleons are very similar to chameleons in that they have those independent eyes like chameleons do. And there are no other lizards that have that ability. So that's something that just really makes them stand out. Another thing is that they have a semi-prehensile tail, whereas the chameleon has that fully prehensile tail. But again, it's similar, but not exactly the same. When it comes to coloring, again, chameleons are going to be very, very colorful. That's one of the things that draws people to them. Whereas the false chameleon just does not compare in that department. They really don't have those bright colors. But I do think that their scales are very unique looking and very cool. And they are gorgeous, stunning lizards. Like, they literally look out of this world. They look like nothing else. So, like, I feel like people that like chameleons like them because they're so unique. And I think that false chameleons are just as unique in that department because they're just so crazy cool looking. Another thing about the false chameleons is that they do not have the, like, mitten claws that chameleons have. They actually can climb up glass similar to geckos, which is very, very cool. Another amazing aspect about them. And the main thing that makes them way more realistic than a chameleon is that they are very, very, very calm and amazing with handling. Like, they will literally just sit in your hand, and it's an animal that looks unique, is very, very cool, has those independent little eyeballs, and will just sit in your hand and tolerate it and not be extremely stressed out or pissed at you. So it's a great option if you want a chameleon because of those really cool aspects, but then you can get something that's handleable and enjoy it more. And the next one that we're going to be talking about, this is like my boyfriend's dream lizard, and I would love one of these. It is the monkey tail skink. So monkey tail skinks, also known as Caruscia zebrata, probably messing that up as well. But these lizards are just out of this world. They are so gorgeous. They have these really, really pretty green coloring. They have these like really big yellow eyes, these really chunky heads. They're the biggest skinks of all of the skinks in the entire world, which is crazy because blue tongues get so big, and I thought that they were the biggest, but actually the monkey tails get larger. So that is another thing to keep in mind. The main challenging part with the monkey tail skinks is that they aren't always the nicest or most handleable. So a lot of them can and will bite and will not tolerate handling whatsoever. And the thing is, when these guys bite, like, you can see their big chunky heads. Like, when they bite, it's gonna hurt, like, really, really bad. That's all I ever hear. I've never been bitten by one. I'm honestly nervous to ever own one because of this aspect, but that is what makes them so challenging. Again, not all of them are like this, so some of them are completely handleable and you may just be completely fine with it, but some of them are just going to be cranky and they're going to bite you and it's going to hurt. So that is what makes them so challenging because, again, they are so big and that bite is just going to be a little bit more powerful, whereas if you were to get the substitute to this lizard, which is also amazing, and the substitute is actually the Mexican alligator lizard, also known as Abronia graminia. So the size difference between these two lizards is the monkey tail skink is usually 32 inches, whereas the Abronia graminia is 9.8 inches. So just the size alone is what makes it better. However, the thing is, with the Mexican alligator lizards, some of them are completely handleable again, But some of them are going to bite. I've heard that they're actually very, very bitey lizards. But the thing is, they're so much smaller and they don't have that jaw strength that the bites are not going to be nearly as powerful as a monkey tail skink bite. So I think that these lizards are similar in that they're both arboreal lizards that are very unique, very cool. They're both brightly colored. They're gorgeous. But one is, I mean, they're both going to be bitey. But one is going to have way more of a powerful bite than the other, so one is just easier to take care of because it's smaller and the bite isn't going to be as bad. So it just depends on you and what you want, and if you're scared of getting bitten by a bigger lizard, this may be another great alternative that's arboreal, bright green, gorgeous, and really cool to keep. And then the last options that I'm going to talk about today are the tokay gecko, because the tokay gecko, we all know, can be pretty challenging. Tokay geckos are known for their personalities of being very defensive, and they bite, and when they bite, it is very, very hard, and it hurts, and people bleed, and it happens. It's just how tokay geckos are. You can tame them down over time, and they can get used to you. You can build trust, and you can overcome that, but not everyone feels that they have the experience to be able to just jump into that and get a tokay gecko. The other thing is that they do get pretty large. They can get over a foot long, so it's a pretty big gecko, and it can do some damage. So, I mean, me personally, I'm not really into them because of, like, it freaks me out. Like, fast movement and stuff and getting bitten by such a powerful animal intimidates me. So I think that if you want a really cool animal like a tokay gecko, but without that personality, there are so many other arboreal geckos that have similar traits that are just much easier with handling and just taking care of. So my options would be basically any of the New Caledonian geckos. So you can go all the way up to a lychee, which they're also going to be some bitey ones, and they're also going to be powerful bites as well, like a tokay. Or you can have a crested gecko or a gargoyle gecko or even a chihuahua. They're much easier to handle. They rarely bite. I've never been bitten by any of my geckos ever. Again, every gecko has its own personality and behaviors and will be a little bit different, so you need to keep that in mind. But if you were to get bitten by like a gargoyle gecko compared to a tokay gecko, it's going to be a huge difference because tokays are just so much larger and so much more powerful in that jaw strength than a gargoyle gecko that's not really going to do much damage whatsoever. So I think that they're similar in that they're arboreal, they're very cool, they're similar to keep. I think the New Caledonian geckos are a little bit easier because they do not have the lighting requirements or the heat requirements like the tokay geckos do. They have the really cool eyes, they never blink, they lick their eyeballs just like tokay geckos. There's so many cool aspects to the arboreal geckos, but there are just some options that are just so much nicer to handle and easier to handle. So if you're someone that's really into a tokay gecko, you love how they look, but you just don't want to get bitten, there are other alternatives that are easier but still amazing and gorgeous to look at. So that completes my entire list for today. Please let me know if you enjoyed this type of a video. Please leave a comment. Let me know if you can think of any challenging lizards and any substitutes for that lizard that you think are more realistic to keep as pets. Let me know your experiences with any of these animals. If you keep them, I want to hear all about it. And yeah, thank you guys so much for watching this video. I hope that maybe you learned something new and you guys are enjoying your time in quarantine. Thank you so much for your support, and I will see you guys in the next video.